writing can seem to have its own language. There's all these different terms that, like, frame, is the horse through, is he on the bit, is he on the aids. What I want to do today is first introduce you to my friend, mentor, and incredible riding instructor, Wendy Murdoch. And Wendy is going to define on the bit or on the aids. This is one of those classic terms that you hear a lot, but oftentimes there's a little bit of mystery as to what does it really mean, and what one person might show as on the bit can actually be totally different than the true definition. So Wendy's going to explain what this actually means. I'm Callie, you're watching the weekly show here at Horse Class, and I'm thrilled to have Wendy as one of our Horse Class instructors explain on the aids for us today.
Thanks, Callie. So what I find is that many people confuse the term on the aids with collection. And collection is something that only occurs when a horse is very well trained and very well muscled. So just as a quick kind of way to define the two, think of on the aids as being in balance with the rider and connected to the rider, whereas collection is a weightlifter really lifting a lot of weight and having power. So oftentimes I have people come to me and say, is this collection when I have this momentary feeling? And the answer is no. Collection is a very advanced thing. It requires a lot of physical strength from the horse. You must see correct muscle development for collection because, again, you have to think about the horse being a weightlifter, sitting down on his hindquarters and pushing his forehand up. You might even think about that as the intro moment of the jump. Just before the horse is about to jump, he should come back on his hindquarters and to propel himself forward. So I just want to be clear about that, because on the aids is necessary to have collection. In other words, it's the beginning steps. And so when we're talking about on the aids, what we really are looking for is a connection from the horse to the rider. And so I'll just quickly put a horse in here. Okay, little shoulder, little front leg. Okay, and we're gonna put the rider in as well. So I'll just make a quick saddle, okay, and I'll just put my rider in. So what we're looking for when we're on the aids is that there's a connection from front to back in the horse and from top to bottom in the rider. In other words, it's a flow from the rider through the reins to the bit, and it's gonna flow all the way down through into that hind foot. And conversely, it's gonna flow from the hind foot all the way up through the horse and back to the rider. So you could think of it as, and why the term throughness comes in, that there's a fluid connection from horse to rider, from the ground, through the reins, to the rider. And when we talk about this, we think about the rider's foot as being connected to the ground, the stirrup acting as the ground. So it says if your feet are solidly on the ground and you have this fluid connection, you can almost think of it like an electrical circuit. We don't want any breaks in that circuit because that's going to interrupt the flow. And so we want to think about either a fluid flow or an electrical flow where the two bodies are working together. And then if the rider communicates something to the horse, say they ride a half halt, it flows, and I'll just do another little color here. So if we think of the rider's back instigating a half halt by expanding, that information is going to go through the bit and all the way to the horse's lower back so that he holds the ground a little longer with that hind leg, and then he can propel himself forward from that hind foot. So it really is this communication, or connection is another word a lot of people use, but it's the feeling of flow all the way through. And I think it's a good example. If you're walking with a friend and you're holding hands and the one person starts to think about going in a direction and you just follow that direction, it's really simple and easy. But if that person whose hand you're holding decides to get sticky or stiff, suddenly you don't have that connection, it's broken, it's not responsive, you feel like they're kind of dragging you in another direction, you're not working together. And so really what we're talking about with on the aids is that there's this clarity of information. If you think about riding a circle or a turn, the horse is riding the circle or the turn with you. If you think of riding a transition, the horse is going to do that transition with you, instead of having kind of a lurch kind of effect or a disconnect or a delay. So I hope that helps you understand what on the aids is. It's really the beginning of collection. In other words, if we're not on the aids, we'll never get to collection, because really what we have to be able to do is get this horse to shift more weight to his hindquarters and lower his hindquarters in order to lift his front end. And that's when we're talking collection. But we need the horse responsive to our aids to be on the aids in order to begin the process of achieving collection.
You've heard us say before at horse class that we're not just about dressage riders. And I think a lot of times these kinds of terms are associated with riding dressage, but they're equally as important for every rider, including trail riders.
Absolutely, because we want our horse responsive and able to quickly respond. Say there's a rock or a boulder or something's coming at you. You want your horse to be able to really quickly respond to your aids, and he has to be on the aids to do that. So whether it's Western, endurance, dressage, jumping, we need this communication between horse and rider so that we can have quick responses in case we need an emergency change of direction.
Yes. So we had a lot of fun creating a course just about on the aids, about movement, and especially about helping you recognize movement, because that's another thing. As you're learning, sometimes it can be difficult to first see the changes, or they appear to be so subtle that you don't notice them. But we had a lot of fun putting dots on horses, using colored wraps, using bells to hear the sound and the rhythm in movement, so that you can have an understanding of the basic anatomy of the horse and how that anatomy relates to what Wendy was talking about here, as well as start to see the movement. And we did the horse vault, which is several of our school horses here, and we looked at how are they moving and what would be the plan to improve their movement, because it's always, it's the training, but it's also the health of the horse and the management of the horse, and there are pieces that go into that.
Absolutely, because if a horse is out of balance, he's more likely to become injured, and there's more likely to be an accident. But when a horse is balanced and on the aids, that's one of the things that happens when the horse is on the aids, is that he's more balanced, then those chances of injury or, you know, disconnecting from your horse decrease. And the other thing to realize is that so many people understand the terms, but they don't know what they're looking for, the specifics of what gives you the clues that your horse is going in the right direction. And that's really one of the things we emphasize in the On the Aids course, is to help you see what we see. What I see when I look at a horse that tells me, yes, this horse is going in the right direction, or no, I'm missing a piece. And that's the first step, awareness to making a change.
If you want to learn more about ABCs to On the Aids, there's a link down below. And also, we would love to hear from you. So leave a comment and just tell us one riding term that you would love to hear better defined. So put that in the comments below. If you're watching this anywhere besides horseclass.com, go there for many more resources and learning about training, about riding, about just enjoying our time with horses. Thank you for watching. We'll be right back.